7:55 na po na umaga, nagbabalik ang The Morning Show. 7:53 na po na umaga, nagbabalik ang The Morning Show. At pag-uusapan natin ngayon yung celebration ng 2011 Down Syndrome Consciousness Month. We have with us Agnes La Peña, ang Vice Chairperson ng event na ito. Maganda umaga.
Hi, good morning.
Tell us, first, no, before we go into the activities para dito sa Down Consciousness Month, tell us first, itong mga may Down Syndrome, how can you tell if merong Down Syndrome ang isang bata?
Well, first of all, Down syndrome used to be called Mongolism,
yeah,
or they were called Mongoloids, and ayaw na natin gamitin yung term na yun kasi it's labeling them based on their features because they have Mongoloid features, you know, the Mongoloid race, you have Caucasian, Malay, but now we call it Down syndrome because it was named after Dr. Langdon Down, who identified it. But they have the features, they have upslant eyes, they're quite short, a bit chubby, they're slow, hypotonic muscles. Okay, so when you see them, bilog, no? So, pag nakita mo, alam mo kaagad, hindi mahirap i-identify. So now we call them persons with Down syndrome.
Pero ito, isa lang, hindi yung mas grabe itong isa kesa dito sa isa.
Ano rin sila wide range, kasi merong mga medical concerns, like most of them have respiratory problems, they have, some have holes in their heart, merong mga, some have pneumonia or merong mga leukemia, extreme cases, may bulag, may bingi, so depende kung ano yung medical concerns. Kaya kailangan immediately na-detect kung may Down sa bata at ano yung mga medical problems.
Marami bang Pilipino na may Down syndrome?
There's 1 in 800.
1 in 800.
That's a lot.
Oh, that's, yeah. So, dito sa Pilipinas, so, unlike in the US, talagang grabe yung pagbuhos ng budget nila sa mga may Down syndrome. Talagang binibigyan ng therapy and all that. Are we already getting to that level or malayo pa tayo sa ganon?
Well, we are getting to that. The DSWD is into this. PGH, you know, it's a government hospital, has a College of Allied Medical Professions, and they offer free services for children, not just with Down syndrome, but with different disabilities.
Ah, so may ano na, hindi na yung kapag may ganong klasikang sakit dito. It's a condition, right? It's a condition. Hindi na kawawa kasi you have to be rich to be able to have therapy for this. Pati yung mga mahihirap, nabibigyan na rin ng servisyo.
Oo naman. Like, where I come from, the Down Syndrome Association of the Philippines, we have a parent support group. We have free clinic. So we tell the parents, come visit us or visit our branches in Cebu or Davao. And we will help you. We have free clinic. Then we can tell the parents, you go to the therapist, they will provide you a home program. Kasi itong mga batang to, gawin mo lang sa bahay yung nararapat. Okay naman ang paglaki nila. Hindi naman kailangan kumasos ka ng... Kasi like therapy is expensive, di ba? Spend 400 to 600 per session. Hindi naman kailangan linggo-linggo dadalhin mo yung bata sa therapist.
So itong mga sinasabi nila kasi dati kapag ang isang bata ay may Down syndrome, hindi siya nabubuhay ng matagal. Is it still that way na bata pa, pwede na siyang yumao, gano'n?
Oh, hanggang ngayon, sinasabi pa rin yun ng iba. Oh. In fact, when my son Jeremy was born, sinabihan ako, naku, baka hanggang mga 8 or 12 years old lang yan. But now, the average lifespan of a person with Down syndrome is 55.
Oh, that's
and we have one member, he's 48 years old. He still paints, he still attends all the activities of the Down Syndrome Association.
So itong mga may Down syndrome, they can live a normal life.
Well, it depends on the condition of the child. But the key here is to do what's best for the child. Early intervention. So, send the child to school, bring the child to the doctor, alagaan ng maayos, treat the child like a normal person. Then you give the child a good chance of living a normal life.
Meron bang mga may Down syndrome na nakakapagtrabaho at nakakapag-asawa?
Nakakapag-asawa, I don't know yet here in the Philippines, but recently it was featured in Oprah na nag-asawa. Of course, it's still with the help of, like they stay in a home for special people, no? Mm-hmm. Nakakapagtrabaho, yes, mm-hmm. meron. And give them a chance. Sabi nga, may nakausap kami, because here in the Philippines, there's a paper making plant, mm-hmm. which not is not only for Downs, but for other persons with disabilities. And this person who trained them, sabi nga niya, ang Downs, it may take a while for them to learn the skill. But mm-hmm. once they learn it, they will not deviate. So yung mga routine work, kaya nila, and we lived in Singapore. There in Singapore, there is what you call sheltered employment. From school, they go to this facility.
Yeah.
You know, the headsets in an airline. Mm-hmm. Sila yung naglilinis, nilalagay sa plastic bag. So they can be useful. They can mm-hmm. be, you know, part of society.
Yes, can, they can be
they
productive
can contribute.
Citizens.
Yes.
Also, this month, no, February, we're celebrating Down Syndrome Consciousness Month. Ano yung mga activities natin?
Yes, we're very fortunate to have the whole month of February mm-hmm. as a National Down Syndrome Consciousness Month. Mm-hmm. On Sunday, we have the annual Happy Walk. Mm-hmm. Our theme is Stand Up for Down. It starts, registration starts at 8 o'clock. The walk proper is at 10 mm-hmm. at the SM North EDSA Sky Dome. Mm-hmm. It's a whole day of activities in the afternoons. In the afternoon, we have amazing games mm-hmm. where the children will compete against each other.
Mm-hmm. Ano to? Anybody can join?
Yes, registration is 50 pesos. Children, persons with Down syndrome mm-hmm. are of course free. Mm-hmm. So please join the Happy Walks. I'd like to invite all the parents, families, friends, therapists, doctors to join Happy Walk.
Mm-hmm. And then after that, what else do you have?
Every quarter, we have the Early Intervention Seminar. Okay, mm-hmm. this is for new parents mm-hmm. and also parents who, for the first time, mm-hmm. want to be to or have accepted their child. Mm-hmm. So this we have doctors. Talk about, you know, there's the geneticists, mm-hmm. the developmental pediatricians, speech therapists, occupational therapists.
So, ano ba yun? Anybody, in for example, yung pwedeng panganak, meron bang mas malaki yung predisposition na magkaroon ng Down syndrome baby kesa sa other women? May ganun ba?
Well, the risk is higher as you age. It starts at 35, uh-huh. 35, and so as a woman gets older, mas mataas ang risk. But majority are from parents, mothers who are younger.
Younger.
So we've had in the early 20s.
Really? So, ito, hindi ba hereditary? Does it have to be
parent? There is a kind that uh-huh. is rare, that uh-huh. is hereditary. So if you see in a family there are two or three, then that's a different kind. That's called translocation. But the most common, you know, is not hereditary. So mm-hmm. my risk of having another child is just maybe just the same as any other woman.
Mm-hmm. And you had your child at what age?
I was 35.
You were 30. Oh, that's
medyo
not
high.
So
pero may high. Sasabing high risk. That's why in other countries, mm-hmm. when you're 35, would you like to have a test or it's an option uh-huh. to abort your child because the risk of having a child with Down syndrome. Mm-hmm. So in other countries, the statistics nila, mas mababa ang cases of Downs because they have an option to abort.
To abort it if they know na may Down. Oh my God, what if hindi pala nagkamali? Oh,
at saka, just in-abort
mo? I mean, you know, at saka kahit na, diba? That's already nice.
It really gives us so much joy.
Yes.
All the parents are happy with their children.
Of course, initially, when pagpanganak mo at sinabi sa'yo may Down syndrome yung baby mo, you're devastated.
Oh, oh.
But then there must be a reason kung bakit binigyan ka ng baby na may Down syndrome, no?
Yeah.
And siguro, do you have therapy or even yung sessions for parents na, especially the new ones na merong anak na may Down syndrome, for them to be able to understand and know how to handle this?
Yes, that's the importance of early intervention.
Mm-hmm.
So the morning session is really just for parents
uh-huh.
to talk with each other, yeah. we allow them to cry, to uh-huh. grieve,
yeah.
and then as much as possible, get over it
yes.
and move on. Talk mm-hmm. with the doctors. What is the best thing to do for your child?
Mm-hmm. And a lot of parents, ano, nakaka-respond naman sila sa ganun. Yes. Oo. Oh. Hindi yung iba, hindi na naka-move on.
Pag i-feeling mo na you're not alone, mm-hmm. we're together in this, and then you get tips from other parents.
Uh-huh.
Sometimes the tips, you know, you read from books, the internet, from your therapist, but then the another parent is saying, hindi, gawin mo to, mas okay to. And we've gone through that.
Mm-hmm.
And we're very thankful that we became part of the association, and we have friends, you know, we call them friends forever, because mm-hmm. we're always together in this.
Have you had cases na siguro some ano hindi talaga matanggap ng parents, tapos kinukulong yung bata, hindi dinadala sa therapy, parang kinakahiya, may mga ganun ba?
Really sad until now is we discover na ito pala may anak na Downs, or we went to Cebu, yung bata naka-cage.
Parang animal, gano'n.
Tinatago, nakakadena, nakakulong. And it's so sad because these are beautiful children.
Yes.
I mean, you know, bring them out. Be proud of your kids.
Mm-hmm. Kapag gano'n, ano, what intervention do you give?
Well, we talk to the parents. So, it's hard. Sometimes it's also cultural.
Yes.
Or may mga, you know, may stigma kasi na yung anak ko, or malas, or they think it's their fault.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes kasi kulang din sa education, like the doctor would say, ano bang ginawa mo?
Mm-hmm.
Anong gamot ang ininom mo?
Mm-hmm.
Or may kasalanan ka bang ginawa?
Wala naman yung, meron ba yung ano, pag may ininom kang gamot, pwede magka-down syndrome? Wala sa ganun yun, ano?
It's a genetic disorder, and it happens at the time of conception.
Mm-hmm.
So, nothing.
So, the parents shouldn't blame themselves?
No, or, no.
Uh-huh. So, yung ganun, anong nangyari dun sa kaso yun?
Well, first, it was my husband. The first thing he did was to call the association, because lucky for us, the geneticist came to the hospital.
Uh-huh.
So she said, you can join. She gave us the brochure.
Uh-huh.
And then my husband immediately called the association. Uh-huh. He borrowed some books.
Uh-huh.
And then when he thought that I'd be okay, we read the materials to him. Of course, we cried a lot.
Yes.
You know, all parents cry when they find out that their child has Down syndrome.
Mm-hmm.
But then, with the help of the other parents, we made it.
So, mahalaga yung merong support group,
yes,
no?
Yes.
Oh, and for other parents to tell you how they got over this and accepted it. But does it take a while before that happens? Matagal
ba yun? It depends. Some are okay the following day. You'd be surprised na okay ka agad sila. Some, malalaki na yung anak nila, teenagers na hindi pa rin
matanggap,
dinadala sa association, or ayaw pa rin, oh yeah. Or sasabihin nila, ay, iba naman yung anak ko eh. Mild case. So, I mean, maaring mild, but you know, there's the denial. Nandun pa rin yung denial.
Yeah.
So, we really want to invite those parents to come and join us and be proud. Kasi, if society sees that, you know, you're proud of your children, and they see that they can contribute, then maybe they'll give them jobs, they'll be more open.
Yes, oo. Even yung mga, like in the US, I see itong mga may Down syndrome, sila yung binibigyan silang trabaho, let's say, in a supermarket, sampling out food, cookies, yung gano'n, no? So, they become productive also in their community,
right,
no? And people accept, parang normal lang doon yun eh. Hindi, dito kasi, medyo parang yung iba, meron ikinahihiya, yung gano'n, which it would be, no?
Yeah, I was surprised because when we brought our son to the US, and I mentioned something about Downs, may nag-comment na, it's nothing. Parang baliwala lang yan. Hindi nila pinapansin. Samantalang dito, we're very conscious na may kapansanan yung anak natin.
Yes. It shouldn't be, you know? Ayun nga, siguro dapat magkaroon tayo ng parang awareness na they shouldn't be treated differently just because they're ganun yung itsura nila, or meron silang kapansanan, no? Do you have a campaign on that? Hindi lang for mga parents na may ganito mga anak, but for other people na who do not understand na pwedeng maka-apekto yung attitude nila towards itong the parents and as well as the children kapag yung kumbaga dinidiscriminate nila, like, o parang sila yung kinahihiya nila.
Yeah, like, so that's why on Sunday, that's the objective, that's the purpose of Happy Walk.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why we're bringing them to the mall, SM Mall. When the mall opens, the children with their families, all wearing yellow with yellow balloons and yellow banners, with a theme, Stand Up for Downs.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, let's accept our children.
Mm-hmm. beautiful. Okay, so good luck sa inyo.
Thank
you. At happy Down Syndrome Awareness Month.
Yes.
It's supposed to be like a happy occasion for the parents and the children to be celebrating this. Okay, so thank you very much at magandang umaga sa
inyo. Thank you and good morning.
That was Agnes La Peña, Vice Chairperson ng 2011 Down Syndrome Consciousness Month. Mababalik po ang The Morning Show. Okay, Agnes.